Hi, this is Mark from LongIslandWatch.com, and today I want to just discuss with you for a few minutes, or probably a little bit longer than that, the term the gray market and what it means, because I think a lot of people are just really confused, either what they read on forums or they read elsewhere, and I just thought, you know, maybe you'd want to hear it from a vendor's point of view. So I'll define it a little bit, and then we'll just discuss it, you know, pluses, minuses, etc. And you know, hopefully it makes you a little more educated in your buying process. So there's white market items, and white market are items that are sold, you know, probably most of the things you buy every day, usually in a store. It could be online. You buy a Sony camera from Best Buy. That's all white market. You know, Sony makes the camera. Watch is on my mind. Sony makes the camera, you know, wherever it might be, Japan, and it goes to distribution through Sony USA, and then Sony USA sells it to Best Buy. Best Buy sells it to you, and you know, that's strictly a white market transaction. And then on the total opposite end of the spectrum is black market. Black market is the, you know, sale of illegal goods, whether it be drugs, firearms, pharmaceuticals, anything. That's black market. It's totally illegal. And then there's something that's kind of in the middle, but not really in the middle. That's why they termed it gray. It's really almost more white. You know, we call it, like, maybe it's tan market. But gray market is just such a derogatory term, at least in my mind. So there's gray market. And gray market is known by a couple of different names. People call it parallel import goods, which is actually a misnomer. That's not correct. Alternative distribution channels. It's all unauthorized sources. It's all the same. It's all gray market. So gray market basically is the sale of non-counterfeit goods. Very important to understand that. If it's gray, it never means it's fake. Okay, so the true gray market means non-counterfeit goods being sold outside of the distribution chain that it was originally intended for. So let's go back to the same example that we did in the beginning. Sony makes a camera and it's destined for the US. It goes to Sony USA, goes through a couple of different distributors, and then that one of those distributors says, you know what, I'm going to sell this camera over to Europe for sale in Europe. Once that camera hits European shores, it is a gray market item. It was an item that was manufactured by Sony under their trademark with their rights and licenses, and it was intended to target into the US market, and instead it was targeted into another market. It's not counterfeit. It's real. It may not have any implied warranties, but it is technically a gray market item. So how does all this pertain to watches? Well, when I started in this business, I started with very small companies from over in Europe or the Far East or whatever, and they didn't really have a defined market, you know, or a defined distribution chain. So I would purchase direct from the manufacturer. So, you know, no problem getting goods, always authorized, never a question about that. But then one day you go knock on the door of one of the larger companies and say, I'd like to sell your product, and they say no. Well, what do you want to do? What are you going to do? If you really want the stuff, there are ways to get it. And that is when people hit the gray market. Able to get goods through, you know, again, non-counterfeit real goods, able to get them from another supplier, okay, and bring them in yourself. Selling gray market is not illegal. There's nothing illegal about it. It's totally legit. Supreme Court has ruled this time and time again. Omega has sued Costco, you know, countless times for selling Omega watches in their stores. They are gray. Those are gray watches because Omega does not sell to Costco, and Omega always loses. Costco always wins. So it is not illegal. It's totally legit. Where do you lose out? Well, you lose out on warranty. You know, if it's gray, more than likely there will not be a manufacturer's warranty. So you'll have to go to the store to get the warranty. So with watches, no exception. So the gray market works by, there are many suppliers, wholesalers, whether they be in the US or overseas, and they will offload their goods. to anybody willing to pay a dollar. So how does this pertain to watches? Well, watches are no different. You know, you've got manufacturers, like I just mentioned, you know, a very big one, but you got Seiko, you got Citizen, you got Orient, you got, Casio, countless, companies, and they ship watches all over the world to their different distribution centers, all legitimate distribution centers. You know, they have headquarters usually in every country. And then from there, it goes out to, various, maybe more suppliers or more wholesalers. And eventually one of those guys or gals turns and decides to sell it outside of their authorized channel. And that's how it becomes gray. And that's how you I'm not going to mention any stores' names, of course. But that's how a lot of these stores that are not authorized get these watches. They're getting it from, people that are just looking to offload the goods. Could they be getting them direct from the manufacturer? Definitely a possibility. If you're a manufacturer or a distributor or a supplier or a wholesaler and you've got all these watches on the books that you have to get off, you will move them eventually. You will get rid of them. And believe it or not, the gray market is the way that all this stuff gets off the books. Like it or not, I'm sure that there are manufacturers that engage in it, even though they turn this way and say, I will never do it. And then they turn this way and say, here's the watches that you wanted. So, it's almost a necessary evil. So as a buyer, where does it leave you? Well, you need to make that decision for yourself. If you want to strictly buy only authorized goods, then, you just ask, are you authorized for this? Are you authorized for that? Does it come with the manufacturer's warranty, et cetera, et cetera? And if you don't like the answer, then go shop somewhere else. If you buy the seller, which is what I always tell people, Google is your friend, right? Go there for 5 minutes, type in the name of a company and reviews or complaints or praise or whatever, and you'll be bombarded with Yelp reviews, Google reviews, Facebook reviews, people talking on What You Seek, people talking on Time, people talking at any forum. They will be talking about different stores, good guys, bad guys, etc. If you buy the seller, then it doesn't make a difference what you're purchasing, because first of all, now you know that it's going to be real goods. And secondly, you know that the seller is going to back you up regardless of what happens in the transaction. You're not happy, it breaks, needs warranty work, whatever. So, you just need to educate yourself a little bit and you'll be totally fine. Now, what brings me to making this video? Well, the ugly truth, and I can't longer say it, guys. Cover your ears if you don't want to hear it. The Seiko SKX 007, 009, 013, those are all gray market watches in the United States. Yes, I said it, and I've told it to you. If you've emailed me, I've told it to you on the phone. This is true. Seiko USA, we are an authorized Seiko reseller. Go to SeikoUSA.com as of today. It's July 6th. Running watch, by the way. Nothing on the other wrist. Sacrilege. And my store is there as listed as an authorized retailer. But if you call Seiko and say, I have a 007 or 009 or 013, need service, they will tell you it's not in warranty because they do not recognize that part number. It is not for sale in the USA officially. It comes in through, ready? Alternative distribution channels or the gray market. You cannot get a 007, a 009, an 013 in this country with a manufacturer's warranty. I guarantee that no matter where you buy it from, simply because they do not understand what it is. It's in a computer system. You type in the number and it comes out and says, we don't sell this watch here. So they cannot cover it under warranty. At least that's my understanding. I've been wrong before, but I've been doing this for, over a decade, 15 years. I'm fairly confident in this one. Citizen's the same way. Casio's the same way. Orient is the same way. There's many Orients that are sold overseas. The Orient USA doesn't bring them in. If you bring it in and you need service, guess what? You're not going to get service here in the USA. You're going to have to go back to the seller. So that brings me again to the point of, so when you're buying gray market, right? If it's from overseas, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with it. Just keep in the back of your mind the chance that if you get it and you don't like it, and you have to send it back, what's the cost of shipping going to be for you? If you get it and it breaks in a month and you need warranty service and you have to send it back to whatever country it came from, what does that cost you and is that worth it? And that is a decision, again, for you to make. I'm really not talking about the higher end of gray, Omegas, Longines, several thousand dollars. Because yes, you can save decent money, but If it breaks, you're stuck with the store's warranty. And honestly, I know we all work very hard for our money, but you know, throwing away a $200 watch, you know, might hurt you, but it's fine. But throwing away a $5,000 watch, that's going to hurt almost anybody. And again, that's just a decision that, you know, you have to be comfortable with, and what makes you sleep well at night, you know, if saving a few bucks is worth it. And this is why there's many items that you'll see for sale online through various vendors. And sometimes there's a disparate difference in price between two different stores, and it's simply because one is authorized and one is not. The authorized one is going to come with the manufacturer's warranty. The unauthorized or gray one is not. Again, decision for you to decide what you like. Okay, so I think that about wraps it up. So just in conclusion, gray is not illegal. It's not counterfeit. And just remember that. If it's counterfeit, it's not gray. At this point, now it is illegal because that's basically a trademark violation. By the seller. It's probably one of the most important things you can ever do in any, not just watches, any industry. You know, if you like the car dealer you go to, you continue to go to that same car dealer because you know you're always going to get good service and you don't have to worry about the after sales stuff. By the seller. And the last thing, you know, make your own determination of what makes you sleep better at night. You want to spend a little bit more and get the manufacturer's warranty and buy from a better company, then, you know, that's what you do. If you want to, if everything is the bottom line is the penny, then you go off and you search for the lowest price and you don't worry about any of this stuff. Again, all things that, you know, are for you, not for me to tell you what to do. Anyway, this has been Mark from LongIslandWatch.com giving you a little dissertation on the gray market. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to the channel if you have not done so. If you have any questions or comments, I'm sure there will be. Put them below, and I will address them as soon as I can. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.